So the question given is, at time t is equal to 0, a particle is at 2 meters, 4 meters. It starts moving towards positive x direction with constant acceleration 2 meters per second square. Initial velocity is 0. After 2 seconds, an additional acceleration of 4 meters per second square starts acting on the particle in negative y direction also. Find after next 2 seconds, velocity and coordinates of the particle. After next 2 seconds means at t is equals to 4 seconds. So here let us form a coordinate system. Let us consider this as our y-axis and this as our x-axis. At t is equal to 0, particle is at 2, 4. At t is equal to 0. After that, up to 2 seconds. Up to 2 seconds, the particle is moving in positive x direction with an acceleration of 2 meter per second. So, particle's motion will be somewhat like this. Let us assume at t is equal to 2 seconds, particle came up to here. And after 2 seconds, an additional acceleration of 4 meter per second square started to act. Means, horizontal acceleration is there. Along with that, a negative y direction acceleration is also added. So, particle will be moving in a curvilinear path due to two accelerations. Let us assume at t is equal to 4, the particle came up to here. I will take this as x1, y1 and this as x2, y2. Now see, from t is equal to 0 to t is equal to 2, particle is having acceleration and velocity only in the x direction. In y direction, there is no velocity, there is no acceleration. So, the y coordinates from t is equal to 0 to t is equal to 2 will remain constant. So, here we can say y1 will be equals to 4. X coordinate will be changing due to its acceleration. So, if you consider the displacement in x direction from t is equal to 0 to t is equals to 2 seconds, Sx we can write it as ux into t plus half ax into t square. Initial velocity is given as 0. So here acceleration is given as 2 meter per second. So this will be half into 2 into 2 square. This will be 4. Displacement will be 4 meters and initial coordinate is 2. So final coordinate will be 2 plus 4. So x1 can be written as 6. So this coordinate we have found out, this will be 6, 4. Now from t is equal to 2 to t is equals to 4. Let us again calculate the x direction displacement. X direction displacement will be let us calculate the y direction displacement. Sy is equals to ui into t plus half ay into t square. There is no velocity in y direction. Acceleration is given as 4 meter per second in downward direction. So, I am taking it as minus 4 into t square. That will be 2 square. So, this is minus 8. Initially, the y coordinate is 4. Now, the displacement is minus 8. So, final coordinate, y coordinate will be 4 minus 8. That will be minus 4. Coming to the x coordinate, consider this time interval t is equal to 0 to t is equals to 4. The displacement in x direction will be ux into t, which is 0, into half ax, which is 2, into t square. This is 4 square. This is 16. In x direction, there will be a displacement of 16 meters in this 4 seconds. Initial coordinate is 2. So, final coordinate will be 2 plus 16. So, x2 will be is equals to 18. So, the final coordinate can be written as 18, minus 4, which is our second part. Now, we want the velocity. Velocity, if you consider the x direction velocity, you can write it as ux plus ax into t. Ux is 0, ax is 2, and x direction the particle is accelerating for 4 seconds. So here you can take t is equals to 4. So this is 8, and this is in positive x direction. So in vector form we can write it as 8 i cap. Similarly, the y direction also initial velocity is 0, acceleration is minus 4 j cap, and time of acceleration in y direction is only from t is equal to 2 to t is equals to 4. So here time of acceleration will be only 2 seconds. So this is minus 8 j cap. So total vector form can be written as vx and vy. 8 i cap minus 8 j cap. This will be the final solution for this question.